Guys, wild dogs! We've just seen one. I just saw the tracks and I said to Jandre, there's an impala that just sprinted across the road in front of us. Yeah, I'll make your way, guys. I'm the only one here. So there we go. It's the lead dog from the Investec pack, if my memory serves me correct. She's quite dark, but she has been leading all the hunts. She's calling. She's looking for the rest of the pack. Now, this is where I saw the tracks. Or is this a young one of the younger ones? No, it does look like her. No, don't go that way. Oh dear, we can't go there. Just keep checking behind us. She might pop back out into the road. Oh, it's so thick in here. She's disappeared. Okay. I'm pretty sure the rest of the pack's around and they will pop up. So I think we're gonna patrol up and down in this area. Let me just see if we can hear them. Oh, that smell. No, we can't hear them. Let's just keep checking a little bit. Now, when with dogs now, you gotta check behind you, you gotta check in front of you, you gotta check left, right. Now, see, we had those tracks here. And you saw how she smelt, but the tracks are in this area. So I'm pretty sure the rest of the packs, as I said, we just saw a single impala dash across the road. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna position myself around here where I can see long distances both ways, and also switch off the car so I can listen for contact calls. Okay, so while Aubrey and I try to find them, again, let's go back to Jamie. Look at this, we've caught up with them. That female headed down to the west, so we decided to check to the west, and we've caught up with some of the pack. They look like they're looking for other members. These are adults that I can see now, not the sub-adults. We can see one, two. Now I wonder which pack this is. Three, I think this is four. This is the one of the bigger packs. And oh, there we go. Dogs everywhere. So probably the Investec pack. Difficult to tell now till we can see. There's some very distinct animals. I said that lead female is very dark, as well as the collared male, and there's also a male with a very specific wound on his shoulder. Oh, there we go, Investec pack. And see, there's the male with the wound on his shoulder that Jandre is following. It's healed up very nicely. Hi, Michael. Michael would like to know how many dogs are in the Investec pack. Michael, 14 dogs in total, 5 adults, 9 youngsters or sub-adults. Hello, puppies! By far my most favorite creature in the African bush. Now, they don't live very long. in this year, in this part of the world, only about 5 or 6 years is only 5 or 6 years in here. They have a really tough life and lots of threats out there for them. Now I'm just going to do a quick head count of how many dogs we can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. But there could be all full 14 here. And some in those in the grass there that could be a little bit more difficult to see. Now Rick was saying, I mentioned that they are heavily endangered, and he said, why? They seem to be such efficient predators. Well, they are efficient predators, Rick. They're also so efficient that they need massive areas. They need home ranges of around 120,000 acres, 60,000 hectares, just for a single pack. And they also often travel outside of protected areas when they disperse, and they're very prone to canine-borne diseases such as distemper and rabies, and an outbreak in such a social animal will spread through the whole pack and wipe them out very quickly. Let's just try and move a little bit. Now, this is quite a sedate wild dog sighting, as wild dog sightings go. I almost wonder if they've already caught something this morning. I can't see any blood on the faces just yet. It's very interesting to see if they get moving again. I wonder if they're possibly waiting for one individual. Or they could just be resting up. Now they would have been on the go since just before first light. Those massive radar dish ears. Constantly working, constantly listening. Now the raven's wondering, why do wild dogs have those big round radar dish ears? Well, all the better to hear you with, raven, the raven. Now, they often will get split up because of their hunting style, and they'll need to call to each other to find each other. And those ears are incredibly adept at picking up sounds, so it's mostly for them to contact each other, because they can get split by big distances while out hunting. Now, as I was just explaining why they've got such big ears, it's so when they do lose each other, they can contact call to each other. And Tam Cam was wondering whether they do call each other. Yes, they do. They have a variety of different calls, from their woo call, which is a long-distance contact call, through to a series of high-pitched squeaks and twitters, and a very deep alarm bark. And you can see that one's got a couple of holes in his ears.